Hi, I'm Jeff. This is Tropical Plants at 53 degrees north. So I have an issue with my Pteris Cretica fern, or my Cretian Brake Fern. Over the last couple of weeks, maybe 3-4 weeks, it has developed what I think is a disease, fungal disease, called Sooty mould. So what I'm going to do is show you the damage and what causes it, and I'm also going to show you what exactly I'm going to do about it and how I'm going to solve this issue, which I think is going to be fairly easy to solve. So let's jump in. And we are in. So you can see a few of my ferns there, and I'll just show you this one before we carry on. This is Pteris quadriaurita, which is a lovely fern with fabulous bronzy foliage. When the new fronds come out, you can just see there, and they stay quite bronze until it's fairly big fronds. This one here has only just started to turn green, really nice thing. But this specimen over here is Pteris cretica, and it did look a lot nicer than this, I have to say, but recently, over, I'd say, the last 3 or 4 weeks, it's begun to develop this stuff on here. What can only be described as soot, like a black stuff on the fronds. And you can probably tell that the newer, taller fronds don't have it on. So the question is, and you can see some on there, look. The question is why, and what's causing this? So this is something known as sooty mould, and you can get it on all sorts of plants, not just these ferns. Some plants produce their own kind of a secretion, which is like a sugary secretion, and this secretion is very easy a place, or easy surface, for the fungal spores of sooty mould to begin to grow and thrive and spread. And when that happens, you get this dark substance on the leaves. It will come off. If I kind of wet my finger and rub it will come off, and the leaf will look very healthy underneath. And this fungal disease, it doesn't actually damage the plant directly, other than blocking out the light from the leaf. And of course, then if the light's been blocked out from the leaf, then it probably won't kill the plant, but it certainly will stunt its growth, and it won't look as healthy as it did before. So we need to solve the issue. But that's just one, and that's quite a rare occurrence where the plant produces its own secretions. For the most part, and this was the factor that I wasn't so sure about, was that generally it's when a plant has a pest. And when a plant has a pest, what happens is that pest secretes, or it usually excretes, this stuff called honeydew, which again is a sugary substance, which then drops on the leaves below, and that then attracts the fungal spores of sooty mould. So I've had a close look at this plant, and you can see the reason why the leaves, or the fronds at the top, are nice and clean. And the reason for that is that they have nothing above them, whereas the ones below do have something above them. They have these fronds, and it's the underside of these fronds where the problem lies. And let's see if I can find one for you to look at. Now straight away you can see there, those tiny little dots there, that is scale insects, and they've covered themselves with like a shell so that they are free to feed underneath. And if I just scrape one away there, you can see that that is the covering for the insect, or the critter. So underneath there, that's where they do their feeding, and they suck the sap from the plant, and again, thus reduce its vigour. So this is the reason why I'm getting sooty mould underneath, because most of these fronds, there you go, scale insect, I'll put for some more. Practically every frond has scale insect on it. So this is a big problem for me, because if it gets around the greenhouse, then I will have the same problem on everything. So what I'm going to do with this, first of all, I'm not going to clean off these fronds yet. I need to sort out the insect problem. And even on this one, look, I can see it's actually on the top. the surface of the frond. You can see it. How I've missed this, I don't know. I've obviously dropped the ball on this occasion. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to spray it. Now the organic version is to spray it with like a neem oil, which I will try at some point, but I have to say, because this is such an infestation, I don't want to miss anything. And neem oil is one of those solution to a problem, that it needs to touch every surface. And that you can see there was an awful lot of scale on this plant, and it is clear why, because I have vents, there you go, and you can see that things can come in quite easily in a greenhouse. And I very often have the double doors open. It's the only way I can try and keep the temperatures down. So I'm going to spray this with a systemic insecticide. I'll move it away from all the other plants. I have checked the other plants in the nearby area and I can't see anything, thankfully, on anything else at the moment. There's nothing on my Masdevallias there. Oh no, that says that's I thought that was a Masdevallia leaf then with a scale insect on. So this is going to get a treatment now. I'm going to give it a full spray, very careful spray, make sure I get everywhere, even though it's systemic. I just want to be absolutely certain. And then what I'm going to do after that, once that's worked its magic, I'm going to leave it a couple of days, and then I'm going to clean these off. So these fronds can be cleaned off with just some like a dish soap, something like a very soft liquid soap solution. You can have a look on Google and you'll find all sorts of recipes for it, but it's basically just a very soft soap. I spray it on, I leave it, and then once it's all dried on it, a few hours later maybe, I'll get the hose pipe and I'll spray it, and it should all come nice and clean. And then maybe then would be a good time to put the neem oil on it as a barrier to try and prevent that from coming back. Now the systemic should work for a few weeks anyway, but I'm just thinking long term, I don't really want to be using the systemic on a permanent basis. So that's what I'm going to do, and it may well be worth me having a look at some of these other ferns down here which are underneath. And you can, I don't know if you can see, I can just see like glistening in the light where the honeydew is dropped onto there, and I can also see beginnings of sooty mould on there as well. So I'm going to have to be very careful that these scale insects have not run amok throughout this area of the greenhouse. So that's how I intend to solve the problem of sooty mould on my Pteris Cretica. So I have a nice short video for today. I hope you enjoyed it. I have to say, I wish I didn't have to make this one, but I did, and it just goes into the bank of how to solve various problems that crop up when you have plants in a greenhouse. And of course you could get this kind of problem outside as well, or even in the house if you have them in a room in your house. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you are interested in ferns, I've got plenty of fern videos. I will put a link in the description to them, or even in the comments. And if you have any other questions about ferns, or you have some comments to make about your Pteris Cretica, please do stick them in the comments. I love hearing from people. And that's it for now. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.